everybody, Christina Hagerty here in Morrow County in our Fusarium Crown Rot trial. I thought today we could just do some quick Fusarium Crown Rot identification. This time of year, after flowering, as the plants are starting grain fill, is a really good time to scout for whiteheads that can be indicative of Fusarium Crown Rot. So what I've done here is dug two plants from our inoculated Fusarium Crown Rot trial. And so this is what we would expect to see in the absence of disease. So four healthy tillers with some nice weighty wheat heads as we get into grain fill. In the case of a Fusarium Crown Rot infected plant, what we're going to see is these white heads that are prematurely ripening. And that's as a result of the fungus, which is soil-borne, colonizing the lower stem and cutting off nutrients and resources, essentially leaving this wheat head out of that grain fill process, which is where we see the effects of Fusarium crown rot yield loss. So to complete the Fusarium crown rot ID process, you just dig a plant that has a prematurely ripening head, and then follow that white head down and remove the lower leaf sheaths. And in this case, it's very brown, and I can even see some pinkish mycelium from that crown rot in the lower crown tissue. Then we can split this open and even see additional white mycelium in that lower stem area. To wrap up, a huge thanks to Dr. Larry Lucher for being such a wonderful collaborator with us in Morrow County to work on cultural management of Fusarium crown rot. And a huge thanks to the Miller and Orem Farms for hosting trials this year. Hope to see you soon.